Hi there! Today we're going to talk about Mephitis mephitis, otherwise known as the striped skunk. I came across this chemistry when I was working on the skunked beer part of that video series. As it turns out, the chemical in skunked beer is very similar to one of the main chemicals in actual skunk musk. But I'm getting a little ahead of myself. First, let's talk about alcohols and thiols. An alcohol is an OH group, while a thiol is an SH group. The R here is just whatever they're attached to. It doesn't stand for any particular atom or molecule. Another name for a thiol is a mercaptan, which I'd heard of both before, but never knew that they were the same thing. A lot of thiols smell like a garbage can of dog poop that sat outside for 6 months and fermented, and they're used pretty fairly frequently in synthetic organic chemistry. Or at least they were when I was still in grad school. You'd tell in about a quarter of a second or so if somebody took a thiol all out of the fume hood, and luckily the smelling lasted for like a decade or so. Anyway, skunks. They have anal glands that shoot out the really nasty stuff, and it's made mostly of thiols. The big three are E-butuene thiol, 38-44%, 3-methylbutane-1 thiol, 18-26%, and 2-quinolinemethane thiol, 3-12%. I know it doesn't equal 100%, we'll talk about that other stuff in a second. I just want to show that these are all three, in fact, thiol compounds, and they give that rotten chupacabra smell to the skunk. Part of the rest of that 100% is composed of compounds called thioacetates. The regular acetate compound looks like this. It has 2 carbons and 2 oxygens, one with a double bond. We'll connect that to the ubiquitous R group to round it out and make it an acetate ester. The thioacetate replaces this second oxygen here with a sulfur. These thioacetate esters don't have any smell associated with them. However, if you react them with water, you get a replacement that yields a carboxylic acid and, you guessed it, a thiol. This is why, if Doggo got skunked, the smell went away, and then jumped in the pool, he smells like ass again. So, Doggo got skunked? What do you do, Hotshot?
Shoot the hostage!
Well, from our thioacetate discussion, we know that if we take a thiol and make it a, well, not thiol, we can probably get rid of the smell. So, much like oxidizing an alcohol into a carboxylic acid, we can oxidize a thiol into something called a sulfonic acid. Luckily, the sulfonic acid doesn't smell like a sewer backed up into your nostrils. Unfortunately, tomato juice doesn't really have enough oomph to do this reaction. However, a combination of hydrogen peroxide and baking soda, which we know is sodium bicarbonate, does have enough oomph to make that happen. And it's safe for your dog or cat, if you care. If you don't have something that breathes, cries, whines, barks, or screams, you can use simple household bleach, which is sodium hypochlorite. But again, it might burn things if they're actually alive. And there you have it, skunk science. See ya!
Brian, I'm gonna be honest with you, that smells like pure gasoline.